Hey everyone, this is Sanjay here. In my previous video, we have successfully installed the Chrome OS onto the internal hard disk, but I don't need Chrome OS for my daily use. So I need Windows and I need a dual boot Chrome OS so that I can use Windows and occasionally use Chrome OS. So I'm going to delete the entire Chrome OS installation and I'm going to install Windows. And alongside Windows, I'm going to install Chrome OS. I'm going to dual boot Windows and Chrome OS. So I am at my boot menu. I'm going to boot via my USB drive, which has a Ventoy image inside it. And I'm going to select the Windows and I'm going to install it. I'm going to skip this part and I will meet you after I install the Windows. I have successfully installed the Windows onto the PC. Deleting the existing Chrome OS on the hard disk. As you can see here, this is the Windows partition and Windows EFI partition, and I have allocated 700 GB for my personal use, and also I have created a 31 GB partition for Chrome OS and another 23 MB for Chrome OS EFI. The partition I am going to use for Chrome OS is the Chrome OS partition, which is formatted as NTFS, and the 23 MB partition, which is used for holding the EFI, is an FAT file system format. I am going to shut down the Windows and I am going to switch to Linux Mint for installation of Chrome OS onto this 31 GB partition.
As you can see, I am in Linux Mint now. I have plugged in the USB which contains the Chrome OS and branch which we have created earlier. If you haven't watched the Chrome OS installation video, I have provided the link in the description and I will also try to attach it in the card above. Let's go to the browser and go to the branch repository. This is the branch repository and we can scroll down to the dual boot Windows and Chrome OS section. This is the dual boot section. In here we need to run these commands. First of all, let's open the disk app. In here, CROS partition for Chrome OS installation and this is for grub. Okay, let's keep this aside and let's start installing Chrome OS onto the Chrome OS partition. Okay, let's start installing the Chrome OS on Chrome OS partition. Just right click and open the terminal. To be clear, I'm opening the terminal within the Chrome OS folder which I have previously created for installing the Chrome OS. So just right click on it and open the terminal. Let's install the necessary packages for Chrome OS installation. I have given the commands which I use in the description below. I have installed PV and CGPT and let's type LSBLK. Everything is renamed and the 31 GB partition is SDB file. So I'm going to keep that in mind. Let's just copy and paste this command and hit enter. And the second command is sudo mount space. The destination partition is our SDB file, which is 31.5 GB. I have just copied this string over here and then hit enter. Sorry, I have made a mistake. I should have added /dev/SDB file. For some reasons, it is showing some error in NTFS partition. I am going to convert it into ext4. Let's go to the disks and click on this button to unmount, then click on this gear button and click format partition. I'm going to name it as Chrome OS, format as ext4. I have successfully formatted the Chrome OS partition to ext4 and I'm going to minimize this and I'm going to rerun this same command again. See here, it is successfully mounted. After that, we need to enter this command, that is sudo bash chrome os-install.sh/src. Since I am already in the home directory, I need to just give the same as recovery.bin. So I'm going to type same as recovery.bin. I will just copy and paste this. The S is followed by the size of the Chrome OS installation in GB. Usually the Chrome OS will take around 10 GB, and the rest will be available for our usage as an internal storage. So I'm going to give us, and the partition size is 34 GB, I'm going to give it as 24 GB, since the system takes 10 GB. I'm going to press 24 and hit enter. Oops, I forgot to give a space over there. Once that is done, it will show something like this. For time's sake, I'm going to skip this and I will meet you after the installation is completed. Once everything is completed, it will give you the menu entry code for the grub. So I'm going to copy this. Let's open the text editor. Just paste it and I'm going to save it in the USB of the installation file grub. You can save it wherever you need, but don't save it in the desktop because it will be deleted once you have shut down the live mint USB. Okay, this is the text file we have just created. I have a USB in which the Chrome OS is installed already, so I'm going to grab the grub from this USB and I will show you how I grab that. If you are dual booting and if you don't have any USB, I will just put these files in my GitHub repository. I will provide the EFI folder for you. So I'm going to show you how I grabbed the EFI from this USB. I'm going to plug it in. Just ignore this. And once you open the disks app, you can see this is the 32 GB pen drive which I have been using for installing the Chrome OS. It has a Chrome OS installed on it, so I'm going to mount this EFI partition. This is the EFI partition, and I'm going to grab this both. This is not necessary, but I'm going to. If you have secured boot, you need to copy this one too. So I'm going to copy both. Let's open the disks app again and I'm going to mount the EFI 24 MB partition for grub which we have created in Windows. I'm going to mount it. Just open it and drag and drop the EFI folder and drag and drop the branch.dir. Once that is done, open the grub.conf file, and we don't need any of this. I'm going to delete this things. Delete. Just open the grub and just open the text file we have saved. Just copy this entire thing, copy, and I'm going to paste it and just save it. Once this is done, just close the system. If you have a fourth generation processor and above, you should be seeing the EFI file in the boot menu. And I'm going to close everything and just reboot the system. As you can see here, my motherboard BIOS does not recognize the EFI which I put into the CROS_grub partition. So I need to add the boot entry manually. So I have already made a video about adding a boot menu using Linux Mint. You can check the video out. I will also provide the link below in the description. So I'm going to boot back into Linux Mint. I'm going to add the boot entry. So for adding boot entry, I'm going to open the terminal and type this command lsblk, hit enter, sudo blkid and hit enter. Let's keep this aside and let's open another terminal and install EFI boot manager. Sudo apt install EFI boot manager. This will grab the EFI boot manager and install it to our Linux Mint. This is the 23 MB partition which contains our EFI folder. Type sudo EFI boot mgr. I'm going to call it as Chrome OS -l space. This is the path of the boot x64 file. Let's go to this, mount the 23 MB partition in this. It is located in EFI /boot/boot x64.EFI. So I'm going to type in as /EFI /boot /boot x64.efi space hyphen b slash dev slash sdb6 sdb, because we have installed the Chrome OS in sdb5, so sdb space hyphen p. The partition number for the partition which holds the EFI folder is 6, so I'm going to hit 6 space hyphen u space root is equal to, for that the part UUID will be in here sdb6, so the part UUID is this one. I'm going to grab that, paste it in the terminal, control shift p, hit enter, and it will add the boot entry. Yeah, here you can see Chrome OS boot entry is created, and this is the grub. When we hit enter, it will boot into the Chrome OS. We have successfully created the dual boot Windows and Chrome OS. So if you like to boot Windows from grub, and I will show you how in this video, and I will come back after everything is completed. As you can see here, I have successfully booted Chrome OS as a secondary boot. So I will quickly set this one up and come back once everything is done. As you can see here, I have successfully installed the Chrome OS and set it up. Everything works fine except the microphone. As of this release, in the next build of the branch, the developer might release the fix, because the testing releases of branch has some change logs about the mic. Hopefully that will be get fixed by the next stable build. So everything works fine, the Chrome OS, the Play Store, we can install apps from the Play Store, and Google Chrome works fine, and I'm not a huge user of Chrome OS, so I have no experience about this, but I will quickly go to the settings and I will show you about this Chrome OS. Let's see the storage. In storage, 13.5 GB is available. The rest is taken up by the system. If you need more storage, you can make a big partition in the Windows so that you can use more space in Chrome OS. I don't have many things going in Chrome OS, so this is just for showcasing purpose. So I didn't add much of the storage to Chrome OS. Play Store is installing some crap to the Chrome OS, so I'm going to head over to the install section. See, it has installed the Google Play Music, Google Play Movies, Play Games. Okay, let's download this. Okay, WhatsApp and File Manager is being downloaded, so let it get downloaded and installed. Apart from that, everything seems working. If you have any questions, let me know in the comment section below, and I'll show you how to add the Windows boot menu entry in grub. If you find it difficult to switch from the BIOS boot menu, I'm going to show that the Android apps also work. I'm going to open the WhatsApp, and as you can see, it asks for the phone number, and I also downloaded the file manager. This is something I use for Android. Okay, this seems to work, and I'm not a huge gamer, and I didn't try to download some games and try it out. So this is it. The Nvidia cards also did not work. Only thing works is integrated graphics from the Intel processor itself. Other than that, if you need to know more, go ahead to the branch repository, and the developer has given many informations about Chrome OS and how to install, and I have just covered the two of those things in this video. So hope this page will help you to figure out something else. Okay, then I'll boot back to the Linux Mint, and I will show you how to add the Windows entry menu in the grub so that you can switch Chrome OS and Windows while booting. For the grub entry, just mount the CROS grub partition. I have mounted it. As you can see here, I have two files. These are the system volume files. We don't need to disturb those. I have created the GitHub repository. for which I have provided the link in the description below. Just download these files. Just open it, and grab the EFI and branch.dir. This is the certificate for secure boot, and this is the EFI folder. Grab those two things and place it in the desktop. Okay, then we can close this. After that is done, we can close the GitHub repository. Just paste the two files over to your CROS grub partition. Just open the EFI boot, and here you can see the grub. Here you can see the grub.cfg file. Just open it, and here we need to add Windows 10 grub entry. This is for Chrome OS. If you need to change the boot order, just cut this and paste it on top of Chrome OS, and this will do the thing. For my machine, the Windows is installed in this disk, and I have allocated 215 gigabytes for Windows, and these are the two other partitions. This is the actual Windows partition, and this is Microsoft Reserved. And the first partition, when you click on the first partition, the partition type will be shown as EFI system. Just copy the UUID of the disk and paste it to the grub.cfg file. I have already pasted it to the grub.config file, so I'm going to save it. We have successfully configured the grub. Usually the Microsoft Windows will always create three partitions, or in some cases four partitions. The first partition is for EFI, second for Microsoft Reserved, and the third one is the Windows, actual Windows installation, and the fourth one may be recovery. I don't have a recovery partition over here, and this is the EFI partition. When you click on the partition, it will show as EFI system. This is how we can identify the EFI system or EFI partition, and we can specify that in the grub cfg file. Okay, let's close everything, and I will show you the grub. As you can see here, this is the grub window, and we have Windows 10 as a first option and Chrome as a second option, as we specified in the grub.config file. When we point to Windows 10 and hit enter, it will boot into the Windows 10, and if you point to Chrome OS and hit enter, it will boot into the Chrome OS. Let's boot into Windows. I will just fast forward it. As you can see here, a Windows is booted successfully. So if you like this video, hit the like button below. And if you like to watch more content like this, click the subscribe button below. Thanks for watching.